Hello. So, let's talk about my personal project. Hey guys, so I'm Richard Lin and currently studying 10th grade on Manila Shaman International School. And in our school, whenever a student reaches grade 10, they are required to do a specific project, a personal project. It's free for them to choose and they need to accomplish it throughout the school year and finish it at the end of the school year. And for me, for my project this year, my topic actually is spreading awareness on how important it is to stay physically and mentally fit for a healthy living body and soul using social media. So let's discuss about my project right now, and I'm gonna talk to you guys about what my project is all about. Backing up my topic will be my entry question, which is how important is it to stay healthy? Throughout the project, we are guided by a report which has four criterions, which is criterion A, B, C, and D. And I will be mentioning those as we go through with this video. So going to objective A, which is the first criterion, our criterion A. In objective A, which is investigating their subclass 1, which is defining a clear goal and context for the project. So for this project, it aims to spread awareness about the importance of at least sweating every day. And because not only is that helping your body regulate with unhealthy or unwanted intakes, but it also is a free medicine for all of us. Not to mention that having a healthy body doesn't only mean a healthy diet will do, but also a healthy lifestyle that includes sweating or sports is also a key for having a healthy and strong body. And moving on, for the global context of this project, it will be globalization and sustainability, as I will be spreading awareness through social media about the importance of sweating and having a healthy lifestyle. And for the next subclass, which is A2, which is identifying prior learning subject specific knowledge relevant to this project. Sweating isn't really new to me, because ever since I was a child, I have been a very, very active kid in school. Whenever there's a sports event in our school, I usually almost join every part of it. And not to mention, there was also a time in my life where I started going away from sports and started getting attracted or addicted to mobile phones and like iPad games. And by that time, it was grade 3 until grade 6, I almost experienced little to no outdoor activity or sports, or at least activities that include sweat. And by that, I started growing until I got very, very fat, to the point where I was obese, to be specific. And during those times, I started having difficulties with breathing and getting dizzy at times. And not to mention, insecurity was also one of my best foes. But anyways, we're getting lost here. The rain is getting stronger, so I'm sorry if there's ambient sound. Anyways, going back to the topic, when it came to choose a project, I thought of the video I recently saw on YouTube, where a YouTuber challenged himself and his fellow subscribers and followers to sweat every day for at least 100 days straight. And the challenge is called the 100 Days of Sweat Challenge, and it's still currently available until now in Instagram. It ended up inspiring me to do this project of mine, as well as, not to mention, my way of releasing stress is also through sports or sweating. And to add up to the challenge, I also included that I will be correlating it to what happens when a person has a sedative or a lazy lifestyle, so that I can do something about it that can relate to my global context. And I chose this topic not only for the good of myself, but also to try and help others, for example my friends as well as other people, and motivate others to at least learn the importance of physical fitness and health, and to motivate them as well to work out and sweat every day too, like what I just recently did. Because as per recording this video, I just recently finished my challenge and I'm done with 100 days of sweat challenge. For the video manipulation, I will be using the professional application called Adobe Premiere Pro. And with this app, I actually have about 2 to 3 years of experience with it already. So all I do these days is just research about certain effects or stuff that I want my video to look like. So like, let's say I want this effect, I'll just research it and then like learn from it and then plug it into my computer, up to my video, I mean. And I do this just to like make my video more interesting and more fun. And it's also a learning curve for me as well, and like a little bit of challenge because some are not that easy to do. And lastly, the last subclause of Objective A, which is demonstrating research skills. So for the research that I will be conducting for this project will include health issues that relate to having an inactive lifestyle or an unhealthy lifestyle, and what are the factors leading to this. And as I did my research, as I dig further on, what I found is that people who have a lazy lifestyle and has a diet that is unhealthy, as well as having a sleep schedule that doesn't exceed 7 to 8 hours of sleeping, are people that usually ends up being diagnosed with diseases that correlates or highly relates to being obese. But not all people that has this lifestyle has a chance of getting diagnosed with a disease that's related to obesity, because like me, I have a sleep schedule that is like below 7 to 8 hours, but I don't really have a disease that or sickness that correlates with being obese, because like I myself am sportly active, so like I burn my body fats as well, so like there's no problem for me for that. But it's just that my sleep is like not enough, but doesn't mean that I can just get diagnosed with disease that relates with obesity. So yeah, it's not all, or it's not everyone. Anyways, moving on, when a person has an inactive lifestyle, it affects the body by burning fewer body fats, which leads to gaining weight, as well as leads to losing muscle strength and endurance, since the muscles are mostly at an idle state for a long time, meaning like they have a possibility where they will shut down. And lastly, bones may lead to becoming weaker and may lose some mineral content, as well as they are rarely used. And continuing, health risks that affects person's body when a person has an inactive lifestyle may include obesity, of course, and heart attacks, and high blood pressure, as well as high cholesterol, and many more, these are just examples. Lastly, since that they have a lazy lifestyle, their bones, muscles, and the immune systems get weaker and weaker by time. For example, when a person sits too long or stays in a couch without moving for a long time, the minerals in the bones are reduced over time. And for the muscles, strength of it will be reduced too, for when a person has been physically inactive for too long, the muscles will start reducing their strength for being idle for a long period of time. This doesn't mean that you're just gonna sit for one day in the couch, you're gonna have this. What I mean is that when a person has this schedule every single day, just like sitting on the couch every day, eating unhealthy foods and stuff like that. For the immune system, it will be weakened, because when a person already has a lazy lifestyle, like what I've mentioned before, and with adding unhealthy diets like processed food, junk foods and stuff like that, like colas, and then they do this every single day, like for like a year, a whole straight year, of course their immune system will lack the nutrients that they need to fight off certain diseases and infections that is trying to enter their body. And not to mention, people that are aging, or like people that are growing older and older every day, are also prone to these types of health problems or health like difficulties mentioned above, as they also become lazier and lazier, or some may even become weaker and weaker, that they have limitations with their actions as they grow older, meaning they won't be able to move as much, they won't be able to exercise even if they want to, because they don't have the energy to do so. Objective B, which is planning. For subclause 1, which is B1, or developing criterion for the product or outcome. So for me to have a good outcome, I will be doing my best to show that I am sweating in every video, and to edit my videos in a way that my audience will be impressed, and to include nice background music so that my videos won't be like lame or boring, should I say, as well as displaying sheer will and determination while working out so that my audience will really like feel getting motivated, hopefully, and as well as pushing myself to the limit even when my body can't cope up anymore, as well as pushing myself to the limit of my mental capability. Even if I want to say I give up already, I'll keep on pushing myself until I've completed the challenge and going to subclass B2 or subclass 2, which is planning and recording the development process of the product. This was the timetable. I'll show a picture here. This was the timetable of my project, and I only included days 1, 25, 50, 75, and day 100. So lastly, for subclass 3 of objective B, which is demonstrating self-management skills. So for me to ensure that I will be sticking with my timetable, I will be constantly forcing and pushing myself physically as well as mentally to sweat every day, even for just 10 minutes, even if I physically can't anymore or is very tired. I'll try my best to push and push and push myself until I've sweat for the day. Anyways, moving on to objective C, which is taking action. So for objective C, subclass 1, which is creating a product outcome in response to the goal, context, and criteria. This is basically process journal. So a screenshot right here, are the screenshot of the post that I've posted on WeChat Moments. And by doing this, I'm hoping that I have motivated someone or some of my friends in a way to at least let them sweat too. As well as my global context is globalization and sustainability, meaning my main goal is to get everyone included with this project, as well as spread like strong message that it's time to get up and sweat for yourself as well. It's for your own good. You're doing it for your own self. Anyways, moving on to subclass 2 of our objective C, which is demonstrating thinking skills, which is basically evidence. I'm gonna show another screenshot again. These are the files that I have on my laptop. It includes my Premiere Pro files, the edited files that I have, as well as the raw videos files, all from week 1 to week 15 of this workout routine that I have. And moving on to subclass 3 of objective C, which is demonstrating communication and social skill, which is also an evidence of my personal project. So I'm gonna show another screenshot here. These are the screenshot of videos that I have posted on my IG stories. These are the days from day 1, 25, 50, 75, as well as day 100. And lastly, for the last objective, which is objective D, or criterion D, which is reflection or reflecting to this project. And for subclass 1, which is evaluating the quality of the product or outcome against the criteria. So to evaluate the personal project that I have done for this year was a success, because I was able to live up with my global context as well as my main goal for this personal project. And I was able to motivate some people to work out or sweat for a day. And yes, it's not a lot of people, but I'm happy to say that I did the part of my job where I motivated some people to at least get off their bed, get off their seat, and just sweat for 5 minutes straight or 10 minutes. And I am proud to say that I did my job there. And to add on to that, yes, I know that I haven't been able to spread awareness about the importance of health yet, or the importance of staying physically fit yet, but hopefully, by the use of this video that you are currently watching now, I'm hoping that you guys, those that are watching right now, right at this moment, if you're still here, at least that I know that you guys will be aware or has an understanding already on how important your health is, and that please do not take it for granted. It is your health. It is for your own good only. Don't let it go to waste. I just want you guys to stay healthy, and just please don't waste your time, wasting your effort of working out and just not continuing it. It's just gonna be a waste of time for you. But if you do continue working out, even if I'm not posting a video anymore, just keep getting motivated. You guys can do this. Just keep pounding it. And with that, I'm hoping that I have done little job of mine, that part, and that I got you guys sweating. And if you did so, comment down below, as this will be part of my project as well. So you never know, you might be included in my project as well. But just a little side note, I did receive some messages that are some from my friends and some from my IG followers that got inspired with my project of or what I'm doing, and I actually got them sweating, so that I actually have proof that what I'm doing right now is actually motivating people as well. So that's a win-win for me, and I'm already happy and satisfied with that, and I'm rest assured that I've done that part of my job. But don't worry if this video has been uploaded online and you weren't able to message me and stuff like that. It's okay, you can still do it, and just comment down below. I'll surely reply so I can motivate you guys even more. And moving on to subclause 2 of objective D, which is reflecting on how completing the project has extended my knowledge and understanding of the topic with the global context. So I was able to do some research that opened up my ideology to a bigger understanding on how important health is, and that we should never ever take it for granted. But it also gave me further knowledge to the everyday things that I do, as well as things that I eat every day. It made me more and more observative about those things. And with that, I also don't do it just for myself, but I try my best to warn my family members as well. And to add up to that, it also helped me encourage my parents to be more aware of what they eat, as well as remind them at times to do physical exercise or work so that their bones and muscles won't shut down since they are also growing old. It's not only for the good of myself, but I'm also including my family members, especially my lovely parents. When discussing my global context, it helped me stay more connected to the people that view my videos daily, as it helped me interact with them easier, and it helped me interact with strangers that I don't usually interact with easier. And with this project, it also helped me gain my confidence, as before doing this project, posting things online that includes a part of me isn't an easy thing before. Like before, I usually hesitate since my confidence was for myself was low. But with this project, it helped me gain my confidence back, and it boosted it too. So hopefully when you guys are watching this video, you should know that you don't have to be ashamed of yourself or ashamed of anyone that you know. You should be proud of yourself actually, and like working out is not just a simple thing, but working out for me actually helps me boost my energy levels instead of making me tired. It actually makes me feel better for myself, as well as like makes me feel good. That's for me, but you guys can find your own way of releasing those stuffs. Everyone's different, what can I say? Anyways, moving on. Lastly, with my video manipulation skills, it also improved over time. If you compare day 1 of my editing skills to day 100, the change is drastic, because this project requires me to challenge myself and find ideas to make my daily videos more and more interesting. So like I'm also challenging myself to like make videos like look better. So with that, I constantly go to YouTube and watch tutorials about certain stuffs and how to make this and that, make it look better so it will be more interesting. So this project didn't only help me with my knowledge about health and physical health, but it also helped my knowledge about certain things that I like to do, such as filmmaking. I like filmmaking, so it also helped me with that part of my life. And lastly, for the last subclause of objective D, which is reflecting on our development as IB learners through the project. This project helped me with being a better IB learner through the ways of making me more open-minded, by making me more aware of what is happening around me and how serious obesity and unhealthy lifestyle is, and why should it be a more important topic to tackle as well. And not to mention that this project also gained me my courage to speak to strangers that I wouldn't normally do, as well as the confidence to post things that includes a part of me. And to add to that, it also made me a communicator, because I was able to reply to people that reacted or asked certain questions about my project, and it made it more comfortable for me, actually with less anxiety as well. And I also tried my best to motivate people that ask questions about how I do it and what actually keeps me going. And lastly, this project also made me a risk taker, as during the duration of this project, I never dared to take chances that would usually fail before doing this project. But with this project, like within this project, like it helped me gather up more information that failure is always a part of success. Without failure, success will never come. And an example of that is with my daily videos. I may admit that some of my daily videos are boring and not interesting, as well as I know that it looks bad, but I still post it. But I won't feel bad anymore because I know that for my next video, I already know what is wrong with what I did last time. So by the time that I will be editing my latest video, I can improve it to be better and much more good looking. So to conclude, this project has helped me become a better version of myself. And with that, I'm happy to say that I don't have any regrets with doing this project, as I know that I didn't only benefit myself, or like I didn't only do good for myself, but at least I know that I helped some of my friends or some of other people. I found a way to motivate them, to help them to at least sweat and stay healthy during this lockdown. And so that is it for my script or my report, for my final report for this project. And going off the script right now, I just want to give you guys a special message. Not really special, it's just a thank you message for you guys. So for those who are watching this, and for those who are watching my daily videos, and for those who watched from day 1 to day 100, I just want to thank you guys for being there. Even though you guys don't see it, but I get the views as my motivation. You guys were still there viewing my stories, and I'm very happy for that. And with that daily view counts, it motivates me daily as well. It makes me exert more energy when working out, giving it all my best and stuff like that. And that's it for me. I just really want to thank you guys, and for you guys, I want you guys to challenge yourself as well to stay healthy and stay physically fit as well. So when school comes back, you know, you gotta have the perfect body, show off with your classmates, maybe not, or just stay healthy at least. And also bring your family members, or bring your family, your parents to sweat with you as well, so that they will also be healthy during this quarantine, instead of binge watching Netflix, eating unhealthy foods, drinking colas, playing games. Get off those electronic devices for a while. Take 5 minutes of your time, 10 minutes of your time, sweat, pound it, hit the playground in your house or even your room. Like what I did, I just worked out in my room. It's easy, no equipment at all, zero equipment, just use your body weight. Sweat, sweat, sweat. You can do this. We can get through this quarantine. We can get through this virus. All I wanna say is stay safe and keep healthy. And I will see you guys soon. And hopefully this video will help you guys understand what my project is. Thank you for watching. Anyways, bye bye. Richard signing off. But wait, so guys, just want to remind you guys, if you guys do actually work out and film yourself, please don't forget to use my hashtag, which is this, or hashtag sweat with MXIS Richard, or I'll just write it down in the description below. As well as don't forget to always, always, always remind yourself and push yourself to the limit and fight that mental block and try your best to sweat for even at least 5 to 10 minutes a day. And stay healthy, guys. Just wanna tell you guys that again. Just reminding you guys. And even now, this video is done now. Sorry for taking up so much time. Anyways, you can get up now. Get out of your bed, get out of your chair, your sofa, your couch. And I need you to turn your phone down, close it, put it aside. And you just start working out right now. Right now. Chop chop. Let's go. Time to work out. Move it. Move your body. Time to move it. Let's go. Chop chop. Anyways, guys, see you guys. Okay, see you guys after this quarantine. And hopefully you guys stay safe. Stay healthy. Don't forget to sweat. Sweat now, right now. Go, go, go. Bye. Can we just talk? Can we just talk about where we're going before we get lost? I've never felt like this before. I apologize if I'm moving too far. Can we just talk? Can we just talk? Figure out where we're growing. Penthouse view, left some flowers in the room. I'll make sure I leave the door unlocked. Now I'm on the way. Swear I won't be late, I'll be there by 5 o'clock. Oh, you've been dreaming about
stop thinking about it. Can't we just
And for that, I will be guide because
that you had.
Nah, take four. With my answer will be this project aims. Take five. Cut. Damn! I can conclude that I have a fast metabolism, but I'm not sure. But I can say this because the chat reflecting on their and that's it for the script. Watching me sweat, I think. I know it sounds weird, but
what? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
And even now.
Name a yellow fruit. Orange.